Children, welcome back to social class. Good morning, everyone. Today, also the same concept we are going to continue, that is socialism in Europe and the Russian Revolution. Okay, so in the last class, we have understood about how the people was, you know, that they started to adopt the idea of the socialism in Europe and how the people were differentiated based on their opinions towards the changes. Okay, how this French Revolution affected the people. Okay, so we have seen about the liberals, radicals and the conservatives and their ideologies also. And we have seen even the industrial society and the social change. Again, I'm going to re-glance that concept and we are going to see the coming of socialism in Europe. The, you know, the entry of the socialism in Europe, how it has been started, and then support for socialism, how the people started to support for this socialism, and then we'll go for recapitulation. Okay, yes, children. So in the last class also, we have seen about the economic, that is the social and economic changes in the society, and what are the factors which affect it. That is, you know, the increase in the towns, that is the creation of a cities in the towns, and then expansion of railways, you know, the industrialization, all those things were the factors. So here what happened, because the people started to face a lot of problems due to this industrialization. So what are those problems we have seen in the last class only? That is, even men, women and children, everyone started to work in the factories just to lead their life, because the life, you know, the cost of leading their life was pretty high and there was no demand for the industrial goods. So that's the reason unemployment increased a lot and the working hours was so long for the people, and it was, and the pay which they were giving was very less. That is, the wages which they were getting was less. And due to this urbanization, that means increased creation, I know, formation of the new cities and the towns, what happened? The housing and the sanitation became the problems for the workers. Hope you guys understood about these problems, right? So to overcome with these problems, the liberals and even the radicals started to support the workers. See here. The solution is, the liberals and radicals also owned the factories. So the maximum factories even owned by the private property owned by liberals and even the radicals. So increased wealth through trade activities, though they started to increase the wealth through the trade activities. Okay, and intended to sustain their wealth. So they tried to sustain, that is maintain the wealth. And needed healthy workforce. Needed healthy workforce means they started to provide some of the basic facilities, ventilation, the proper working conditions for the workers. Okay, and tried to improve workforce by giving freedom to individuals. So they started to provide some freedom to the workers, improve the workforce. So by providing some freedom to the individuals are the workers, and they, that is the reason even workers started to support. The workers supported these liberals and the radicals, you know, groups for the changes, because they were struggling to bring the changes in the society. Okay, hope you guys are understanding, right? This industrial change, how the people were struggling a lot. After that, what happened, you know, this, the many people were struggling a lot due to this, you know, the problems. So later what happened, this, the revolutionary organizations, they, you know, they plan to start. Their main idea, what was their main idea? To control this private property. Yes or no, children? You know, the, you know, whatever, the conservation, whatever. The maximum, the private property was owned by the few people. So the concentration of this private property from the few people, they were struggling to overcome that. And they wanted to start the you know, the maximum population involved kind of government, judiciary, the freedom to the rulers. They were not expecting the monarchical government, or we call it as a, you know, the aristocracy kind of government. So that is the reason nationalists, liberals and the radicals wanted revolutions to end monarchical government. So they thought that simply we cannot, you know, overcome with this monarchy. So what they have to do? They have to do some revolutionary activities to overcome this or to stop this monarchy kind of government or the administration. So that is the reason what they started to do. The revolutionary organizations established in France, Italy, Germany, Russia. So earlier, whatever we are seeing now, the countries, for example, Russia, it was not just like how now Russia is. It was just an empire, children. So it was just an empire. So which has involved even Poland, and now we call it as a Poland. Everything was within this Russia only. They did not have the proper map. So that time what happened? This people, this nationalist people, liberals, radicals, to bring the changes and to end this monarchical government, they started some revolutionary organizations. Okay, see here. Forming nations. So they wanted to form the new nations where, you know, it will not be having this, you know, this monarchy. See here, to overcome with this monarchy or aristocracy. So where the people will be having the freedom, rights. See here, the nationalists believed revolutions would create nations where all citizens would have equal rights. So that was their main idea, children. Okay, so that is what their main idea. So that is the reason they were struggling a lot. So this nationalist believed that only through the revolutions they can create the new nations, the new nations where all the citizens, all the population, people will be having the equal rights. Okay, and you know, here we can see that the Giuseppe Mazzini conspired to form a nation after 1815. So he was one of the, you know, he had the ideas and his books and all. Even the Indians were reading a lot about his books. He is a Italian, you know, the writer. So he was struggling a lot to create awareness about the people, about the, you know, the way the nations to be formed with, where the all the people will be having the equal rights. Hope you guys are understanding right, children. He inspired, the Giuseppe Mazzini inspired the all over the people, not only within the Italy. He started to inspire the people all over throughout the world, including India, including Indians also. For example, even the Rajaram Mohan Roy and all those people were inspired by this, I know, the ideology of. Okay, hope you guys are understanding right. So we understood about the problems of the industrialization and what are the solutions we can see, and then how this nationalist, liberals and the radicals, they were trying to help the, you know, the workers, the poor people, the, you know, the workers of the factories. Okay, and they were trying to create, you know, they believed only through the revolutions they can end this monarchy. So that is the reason they started with some revolutionary institutions or the organizations. Okay, and then through the revolutions only they create, you know, they thought that they can create the nations where all the citizens will be having the equal rights. Okay, see here. The next thing, it is about socialism. So, okay, guys, so we have seen the nationalism, French Revolution, they struggled a lot for the equality, freedom, rights, everything. So what exactly the meaning of this socialism? What do you understand by the socialism? Yes, here they are telling that socialism means where, you know, whatever the property or the government or the state will be having the maximum power than the individuals. Okay, here they are opposing the private property. The individual should not have the private property. It has to be owned and controlled by a state or the government. So that is called as a socialism. Okay, see here, the socialism, a philosophy and a political idea where they were opposing this private property. They were opposed for the private property. Okay, make a note of that, children. They opposed the private property because they were expecting that, you know, the property, the country's property should be owned by a state or a government where all the people can be used that. Okay, see here, socialism in Europe. So how the socialism started to come to the Europe? See here, it advocated economic equality for working class. The main idea of this socialism, which started in Europe. So as I told you people, what exactly the meaning of socialism means? That is what all the people has to be treated equally, and the property which has to be owned by a state or the government. Okay, everyone will be having the equal rights. Okay, see, and then revealed first time how society should be structured. So in this socialism, they try to reveal how the society has to be structured, how the society has to be treated, how people has to be treated. Okay, and then socialists wanted property to be owned by the whole society and not by individuals. So that's what I was telling you people. That means this socialist people, the nationalist and the socialist people, they were struggling for the socialism. Yes or no, children? So what was their main idea? The main idea, they were expecting the property to be owned by the whole society. It should not be concentrated only by the few individuals. So, for example, if only few individuals has got the property, do you think there will be a growth of a country, economic development of a country? No. So, that is a reason for the benefit of the society. They were expecting that the whole society has to own the property, not the only the individuals. Okay. And considered private property. Excuse me. Considered private property as root of all social evils. So it is one of the basic root. This is one of the reason for the, you know, all the social problems which they were facing. Okay, so they, you know, they thought that, they considered that the private property as a root of all social evils. Okay, hope you guys understood right. So now we have understood about the industrialization, that is the industrial change and the social change. We have seen how the you know, how the industrialization affected the life of the people. Okay, how the people were struggling and they had a, you know, the long working hours and very poor. Yes, the long working hours and, you know, the poor wages they were getting, and then yes, they were struggling a lot, and they did not have the proper housing facilities and the sanitations. All these problems the people were facing. So what are the solutions we have seen? This radicals and the liberals helped them because they were having the maximum private property, so they tried to comfort this workers.